Hi, my name is Ron Johnson, and I'm your mentor coach. And what I do is I help people that are stuck, unfulfilled, in the place they don't want to be, and want to live much better lives. Today, I'm going to talk about transition. I posted yesterday, yes, I am leaving California for good. I'm born and raised in California, from California, been here my whole life. I'm going to Bellingham, Washington. When you go through life, all of us at this time right now are going in a place where we want to transition out of something. You'll be transitioning out of a relationship. Transition to a new job, finding a life partner, getting married, getting engaged. All these different transitions are constantly happening to you. But most of the time, you focus on only the big transition. Quitting a job, new career, going to school, getting my kids off to school, whatever it may be. Most of the time when those transitions happen, we're right at the edge and we do not take that leap of faith. We're not go, we say, oh, the edge is there. We look down, we see it, and we get frustrated because we think about all these negative things that can be happening, and it consumes our reality, and it becomes what we see. All these negative things that could go wrong instead of what can go right. So I'm talking about my journey. I'm living in California. I'm going to Bellingham, Washington. I'm transitioning. That means that everything I've known or everything I've worked for the last 5 years in the fitness business, as far as being a personal trainer or a life coach, will change. I'm 100% in person with my clients right now. And obviously, those that are in person cannot travel with me. And because I'm going to a different state, of course, what do I do? The fears that are coming up is lack of money. The fears that are coming up, how would I make more money? The fears are coming up all ways around money. Because me, that is my personal belief system, meaning lack of, and that's lack of money. So what comes up is the fears of not having enough. Each person may be completely different. Some people that transition may not have the fear of lack. They may have the fear of how many friends, the fear of my find a restaurant. I told a client yesterday, hey, I'm transitioning. She says, oh, wow, how do you do that? I can't live in a small city. I need my Chinese food. I need my culture. Me, I transition. So each person has a different belief or a different way to transition something. Mine was lack of money. But then I started saying to myself, if a quarter has two sides, we know there's a heads and we know there's a tails. Right now, all I can see is the heads, which is I'm leaving my full-time fitness business. I'm transitioning out there. I have to get reestablished. I have to make money and all this kind of stuff's coming up. But also, there's another side to the quarter, which is the tails. So as I feel this fear of things coming up, lack of, I look at the heads of the side. So what am I gaining? I'm gaining a better environment. I'm going to have more space. I get to hike. I get to have more life balance. I'm happier. Those that live in California know cost of living is very expensive. And for those that do not, so let's give you an example, a two bedroom, two bath apartment will run you pretty much between $2,500 and $4,000 per month, not including your PG&E, not including your cable, not including your internet, not including water, trash, whatever it may be per apartment. So it means you got to make a certain amount of money just to pay your rent. That's include renter's insurance or anything else, your car payment, whatever it may be. But I always think about this. When I look at the quarter of the side and those are transitioning, basically ask yourself some questions. What do you want? Why is this important for you? So ask myself, what do I want in my life? Well, I want to have more life balance. I want to travel more. I want to hike more. Bellingham has that. Also, same time, I want to transition out of becoming a full-time trainer to becoming a full-time mentor coach, helping those out there that are transitioning as well. So I'm going to focus on that. Now, of course, all these fears will come up, but I'm thinking all the outcomes I want. Because remember, life is not short term, life is long term. I've only focused on the short term, which is right now, but I have another 20, 30 years or 40 years of my life. I'm going to focus on 30 to 40 years of my life because that's what it builds up. Everything I'm doing right now has a plan and a purpose. I'm trusting that process. Now, that may sound very vague about trust the process. You are where you are at a place where you need to be, but it's very important for you out there to realize you're at the place you need to be because everything you've done in your life. So me taking and passing IPEC certification a year ago, I actually passed it this year, but the school got started a year ago, was purpose for me. Me shooting this video is a purpose. Me helping people is a purpose. Me transitioning out of a personal trainer, becoming a full-time life coach is important to me because that becomes my purpose in life. See, I'm trusting the process and know I am where I am and knowing that I need to be where I am right now because I myself want something different. Training is great. I love helping out people and I love seeing our bodies transform, but I know I want a bigger impact. You know, I didn't say one thing earlier. I want to become a motivational speaker. So point me saying all this is knowing that you've got to figure out your why and your purpose and work towards that in life. And that's when it comes to transition become much more easier. If you only focus on the negative, there's no room for positive. So every time this, every time you think about one thing negative, think about one thing positive. Every time you think about one thing negative, think about one thing positive. So that way, every time it's even keel. If you always think about 10 things negative and one thing positive, you're never going to win. So replace that. Take a piece of paper, 8.5 by 11, cut it down the middle. Put one side negative and one side positive. So when those thoughts come up, write down the negative. And at the same time, you have to write down the positive. Before you know it, you keep doing that, and there won't be any more negatives. It'll be only positive because you transition your thought process. See, everything we want in life is about transition, and also transition your thoughts and transition outside your comfort zone. So those out there that are in transition, take the leap. You will land on your feet, guaranteed. You'll be at the place you should be right now. But only way to do that is build self-confidence, self-assurance, and know you will make it. When I transitioned from my full-time career to becoming a full-time personal trainer, first thing I said to myself, I will make it. And it's 3.5 years later, and I've made it. I helped a lot of people. I'm transitioning again and becoming a full-time mentor coach. So in conclusion, those out there that are stuck in a place where they don't want to be, are stuck in a place where you need help, I help those individuals because I myself was there. I've been stuck. I had low self-esteem. I've been unfulfilled. And what really happened in transitioning my life is I started taking my life and things I wanted and doing something about it. I can sit there. I can wait for something to happen. I can think about something to happen, or I take the action. And when fears come up, now I just take action. Okay, action with fear. So anytime you ever have fear come up, if you take action, it will prove fear is not important. False evidence appearing real in that sphere. At the same time, I said about lack, my belief system, lack of money, lack of not having enough. I was broke in my life. I've been there. It sucks. Can't pay your bills. Struggling, right? Car breaks down. You know, I remember just having my car check engine light come on. I would get almost like I'm gonna have a heart attack. I mean, my heart's pounding. I don't know what I'm gonna do, how much it's gonna cost, you know, repairs. But when I start transitioning my thoughts, more positive outcomes in life are achievable. But the process starts with you knowing that you can transition and just be brave and take the leap. Again, this is Ron Johnson, mentor coach. And thanks for listening to my live video on transitioning. I'm leaving California. I'm choosing faith because I know I make it over fear.